against the world number one. He looks so intense and he's motivated. And it means that the number 13 seed Park Sung-wan of Korea, whose world ranking dropped 2 points, 2 places since last week. Well, he's in great form too, because look who he disposed of in the quarterfinal. All of his matches in 2 straight games, and he's beaten 2 players who were seeded above him. Tianlin Nguyen and of Vietnam, first of all, and then Lin Dan, 3-time defending champion in yesterday's quarterfinal. Now that's very ominous for all Korean fans. They've played 7 times previously, and South Korea has won them all. Last time they met was in the Thomas Cup qualifying Asian zone.
Indonesia. On my left, Park Sung-wan, Korea. Park Sung-wan to serve, level play.
So the Korean, the far side of the court, Park Sung-wan, the number 13 seed, up against the former world and Olympic champion. Southwick Hilliard to Indonesia. Of course, the first question I have to ask you, Ian, is they both had big results yesterday. They both won matches they weren't expected to win.
Southwick Hilliard
beating the world number one of Malaysia. Park Sung-wan beating Lin Dan, then reigning world champion and Olympic champion. Sometimes after a big result, a big win, there's a little reaction to that. After being on such a high, there's inevitably a bit of a low.
Yes, I think that's more likely to be the case with the younger player here, Park. Less used to being in these situations, whereas Tafik's got all of that experience to draw on. Been at the top so long.
Amazing,
he's still only 29. I think Tafik will deal with that situation. I don't see a problem for him. My question is whether how Park deals with it.
It'll be very interesting to watch the tactics of Tafik
and Dayat here. He found a tremendous game plan yesterday to counter the speed and physicality of Lee Chong-wei. I wonder what he's going to come up with against this tall Korean player today.
Yeah, you mentioned it's hard to believe that Hilliard is only 29 years of age.
Two.
Look back, 10 years he was the number one seed at the Sydney Olympics. He won his first ever major competition before the days of the Super Series. It was the Grand Prix that were the highest level of tournament when he was just 16 years old. Decision from the Indonesia could have gone away with it.
Four,
yeah,
two.
What's going to land in? Is right to hit it in the end. Good, too tight.
I'm sure the last words of the Korean coach to his player before this game started were, make sure that you get into the game early, don't let Taffy get off the quick start he got against Lee Chong Wei. Because with that quick start yesterday, it had two effects. One, he was able to control the tempo of the game, and two, it really stressed Lee Chong Wei. I have to say, he got very, very stressed with the situation with Taffy starting so well. I'm sure the Koreans going out there to try and impose his probably superior physicality on this game as early as he can.
Biding his time, patient play.
Six, two.
It's well off the back line.
Just wonder whether we're going to see the same patterns in the previous semi-final. The older experienced player getting off to a good start, managing to control the first set and then just gradually losing the edge physically. It's been a very, very long, hard week for the singles players. And in very, very hot, humid conditions. I guess that's going to have an effect here.
At the moment, the Korean is just not reading what's coming at him. He's slow to react. Six straight points.
Seven.
It's not giving Tafik time and space on the front of the court. It's already sound tactics.
Just tell us what the qualities of the tall Korean are.
I think we've seen it in a couple of the rounds already. He defends extremely well. He's got a very good reach. And that allied with his leg strength, he gets down low very, very well for a big guy. But more importantly, he recovers very quickly as well. And finds a good position on court very quickly after the defensive shots. Noticed a big improvement in his game recently. He's around the net. Quite poor technically around the net in the younger part of his career, but a good example there. He's really improved that in the last 12 months. See his defence there. Fantastic reaction.
Rocket and he tried to play that defensive shot. Clarkson ran. But it's interesting to me when you talk about his wonderful defence. His first ever success at the World Junior Championships, he won the gold medal, Clarkson ran, in the boys' doubles playing with Hang Sang-kyu. So he was brought up playing singles and doubles, and I know it's something that we've discussed and about the development of young players. It's so good that they start off with all disciplines.
Koreans have always done it. They've always insisted on their players playing at least two events. The first time I came across the Olympic next champion, Lee Hyo-jung, was in the All England singles, and they coached a French girl against her in the first round of the All England singles. Now,
eight,
when you look at her now,
four.
Over the last 5 years, she's been one of the top doubles and mixed players in the world, and you really wouldn't think that she could play singles at all. But because she was a little bit big and lacked a bit of coordination, the Koreans insisted she play singles for the first 3 years of her career. So she played singles and doubles. Didn't start mixed until they withdrew her from the singles. They felt she'd got enough agility. Tafic's winning, he's having to hit so many shuttles to win these points, and I just wonder whether that's going to be a factor later in this match.
Service over.
Sorry to get his double screw there, good reactions when the shuttle was driven at him. I also remember in World Juniors, Hai Tai Kwon playing very good singles. As you can imagine, very, very aggressive. Someone who later became the Olympic men's doubles champion. He played singles a little bit like a Danish player, but he played singles
six,
all the same.
Nine.
Yeah, same part to one, yeah. There's a fine singles player.
Fantastic singles player. Only ever really played it later in his career for his country in Thomas Cup situations. He beat a lot of the world's best players.
Yes, I think perhaps in Europe we could learn a thing or two about the development of our younger players
six.
Going. Yep. In all disciplines, before specialising.
Said it before, singles develops two real key elements for me in badminton, and that's one, decision making. You're on your own on the court, you've got to make your own decisions and learn to do that. And the second one is the agility required to be a top badminton player in any of the disciplines.
Deceptive, simple push from Tafic, really actually in the rally. He got to the mid-game interval with a final point advantage, just 10 minutes of play.
10 minutes of play, but already 3 or 4 rolling rallies.
Yeah. It's remarkable to think there you are, two players that were in the final of the All England 11 years ago and nearly are in the semi-final World Championships, and those two safe players are still at the very top of World Badminton.
11-6, play.
There's a common element, and I think they're both such good technical players, and they don't rely all the time on physical abilities. Such great techniques that it's allowed them to continue in the game longer than the more physical type players that you tend to get in the game
seven,
at the top of singles
11.
At the moment. They're master technicians, both of them, and tacticians.
Eight.
perfect.
Service over, 12, 7.
There's a moment here where he hangs. It all stops, and that just makes his opponent flat-footed because the preparation's so early, it breaks the timing of his opponent's push-off to defend. Fantastic technique. Hang time in basketball terms, I think.
Good job, Vince.
13-7.
Service over. 8-13. We were talking about earlier, Adrian. Clark got a lot of spin on that shuffle, something that he wasn't doing a year or so ago. To hit that cross-court clear and then set up in defence, but Tappert crossing again, which is quite rare, the double cross. Interesting tactics. He's probably seen something on the video, part favouring the straight defence after this cross clear, he's taken advantage of it. Parker able to lead the flip this time. It's soft in. Hangs back rather than commits to coming forward. Obviously it plays soft, tempting Tafik into that. And up he gets for the interception.
Smashes that we were witnessing yesterday when he beat the Malaysian in the room on the one reach on way. Fastest of the game so far from the Indonesian.
Tafik's been. I think he thought Tafik would be coming out trying to win quick points against him, and he came out ready to defend, and Tafik's been really patient. And as you say, Clark's a little bit lost tactically at the moment. What I like about Tafik, we've seen him get some spectacular smashes, but he's only using to win the points. He's not wasting energy hitting lots and lots of smashes. When he sees a real opportunity, yes, he hits the smash, but he's not wasting any smashes. makes them all the more dramatic when he does hit them.
There's his coach Andoyo. Yeah, there again. He's opened up an 8-point cushion.
18-10.
Gained the point before, very, very patient. Kept the pace out of the rally. And then Park starts the next rally at the same pace, and Tafik immediately changes the tempo. He's really confusing his opponent with these switches in pace and direction at the moment. With a tactic that's really confusing his opponent. He found tactics to do that to Lee Chong Wei, and he's found tactics again today. Totally different to the game he played against Lee Chong Wei yesterday. Really a masterclass in tactical play at the moment.
Push that wide. A run
20.
Of 6 point points.
10.
Gives the Indonesian now 10 game points. And that was really nice stuff. Turning back the wheels is tough to play at the moment. Opening game in just 19 minutes, 21-10 in favour of the former champion.
Jill, I think they'll both be surprised. I think Park and his coach will be very surprised at how patient Catherine's been. Catherine will be surprised at how easily he'll be able to control the tempo of that game. Very interesting to see what he does at the start of the second set. Very often he likes to start slowly in the second set, just to judge the physical situation of himself against the opponent. But I just wonder whether he'll take the game that's come out quite quickly and just try and get control of this second game early. It's been very tempting in the first set, isn't it? We've seen what happened to Peter this morning when Peter won the first set very easily. But Peter came out a little bit tentative, I thought, at the start of the second one. Dropped the tempo a little bit and paid for it. I'm really interested to see what he does here.
He's
always in control, and yeah, I think we said it at the time that he actually lost 4 game points, and I think that was when the momentum of the game changed. He was in control the whole way through. Talking of control, here's the statistics. Smash winners, yep, Tafik. That's the difference.
20 seconds.
And you see, he's maintained his lead all the way through that game. Got control early, kept it. Yeah. Not a lot to say there, really. A few more errors from Park, but I think they're forced because he's just been so surprised and ill at ease with the tactics that Tafik's implemented.
So, Indonesian getting the second game on the way.
It's
a hesitant start to the game.
Yeah, and we've talked earlier in the week, Ian, about head-to-head encounters and whether it has an effect and so on, but when you've played against the player 7 times, you've never beaten him. Surely that must start playing on the Korean's mind here.
I think that's one of the fascinating things about badminton. It's the clash of styles. because Park, he beat Lindan, but he's actually got a good record against Lindan.
Very good record.
You know, and how is that? Because Tafik hasn't been close to Lindan for a long, long time. There's a big difference in level over the last 2 years between Tafik and Lindan. Lindan vastly superior, say, but Lindan has problems against Park, and Tafik's got a 7-0 record against Park himself. I mean, it's really interesting, these individual matchups.
Yeah, Park's around, beating Lindan now five times.
I remember around the Olympic time, there was a comment from somewhere in the China camp saying that Lindan was in great shape, really comfortable. He was asked if there's any players that he didn't want to play, and said, well, the player he's got the worst record against is Park, so Park's a dangerous floater. And if you get in the draw, he got Park with home advantage. He got through that one and never looked back.
One, love.
Magnificent
one.
Timing.
Super Bowl demonstrating his technique.
And one.
Yeah, it's a little bit short.
Tafik. Two.
Mark is a tall, rangy player. Good reach. Not only tall, but he's got a very good reach. Set that quite comfortably.
What?
It was interesting in the early stages of that rally. Tried to pull that thick shot it. The green's head.
Three.
And he's using
two.
Some really good net. Looking for the drop shot.
He's trying to keep his opponent off balance all the time. His opponent just starting to read that straight flick up the line now. And he's hanging back. He's not coming in as quickly as he was in the first set. He's just hanging back, looking for those deceptive flicks to the rear court.
This is where Park is going to really try and work his opponent physically.
Nice. Got off the ground, counted the smash, put across the shuttle. Put it down close to the net with very little pace on it.
I know that Park has been turned in the past to win the Asian Badminton Championships in 2008. And I wonder with his inexperience, I mean, this is a major, major match for him. He hasn't won that many tournaments around the world in comparison to his opponent of today, whether with his inexperience he might get a little bit ahead of himself, because he knows if he can just get through
three,
this one,
four.
He's got a real chance in the final, because he's already beaten Chen Jin in the past.
Yeah, these are the mind games, aren't they, of individual sport. You've got to play in the moment, you've got to play the next point, the next match.
Four.
You've got to play your opponent on the court, and not the hall, not the conditions, not the crowd, not the umpire. Great focus at this level. Young players, sometimes they do get a little bit ahead of themselves.
The middle over. 5-4.
fastest smash so far. That was 266. Precision.
Kuznetsova.
Fantastic.
5-4.
Spinning the shuttle off the tape. Second set that it's Park that's been playing all the badminton. Certainly it's Kapoor with a 1-point lead. Forced the short lift with the touch from the net charge.
Oh.
And a nice exchange. Park feeling compelled there to take Tafik on the net, and this time coming out on top. Trying to play the spinning net shot from just a little bit too far away from the net. Again, just these little subtle changes in play. Just keeping his opponent off balance, out of kilter all the time. Fantastic to watch. That's a great shot there. Different sorts of net shots
used in different situations. So if you want to try and force the short lift, you'll do a tight spinning net shot, tumbling net shot close to the net. But if you want to sort of draw your opponent into trying to play a tight net shot themselves, just as you say, you play it back from the net a little bit, so it's more difficult for them to then play that accurate shot.
A little bit of energy here, but he's not fully committing to the smash in the second set so far. He thinks it more as a building shot rather than a finishing shot that he was doing in the first game. Just wonder if he's saving himself for an effort around the mid-game break. A little short in length from this end as well, Taffy. See here that this is intercepted. Yeah, good metre and a half in the court.
Yeah, and did you notice the way Park was immediately following into the net? He knew he'd broken the string of the racket. Said to himself, well, I might as well really dash in, because if it comes back, I'm going to have to go for the kill.
Points
to the Korean. So much for Arthur, Rick. Hurry up, we're going to make a big push before the mid-game interval.
Nine.
Virgil Smash-Hughes is the winner.
It's not brute strength, is
it?
282. Goodness.
Well, like I said, it's not brute strength, but there's a fair amount of strength all the same.
Yeah, fastest of the match so far.
Line judge, please.
Just to give you an indication, 2 kilometres per hour is, that's 175 miles per hour.
Thank you.
I think he is putting a break in. He wants to be in contact at the turn. I think he's still thinking he can do this in two sets.
Pretty hard for these rallies. He's just released for the hard work.
I think we'll see very quickly the Tafiks thinking two or three sets here.
3 points behind. It's easily closed down.
We've seen him before, though. Julie makes his mind up very early.
That's the sort of thing that unfortunately has been missing from his game in some tournaments recently. The season really refusing to let the shuttle touch the ground this side of the net. That was brilliant retrieving.
That was true. That's really up for this one.
9-11.
Someone bringing something a little bit different to the court tactically. Taking the pace off, lots of drops from the rear court, tempting his opponent to play the block so he can get in and play the spinning net shot. And then he got one in. Up the pace.
Just going to point in it.
Frustrated with that.
12, 10.
I'm often seeing this if I can, that shot.
Ten.
This second game.
He did use against Lee Chong-wei yesterday, and that's bringing his blocks into the middle of the court. One, to tempt his opponent to play the spinning net, but two, also to reduce his own court and increase the possibilities of an interception.
Service over 13-11.
Change of pace, smash to the body. Turn in 1 point, 12-13. From Park, once he got the short lift, very quick to apply the pressure. Good angle jump smash from the rear court, and following it in very positively, killing from the front court. Centre of the net and the fast flicks into the back two corners. Change of pace just deceiving his opponent.
That's perfect.
Beautiful control.
And he's back level. And the grimace on the face of Parkson Wright, trying to become the first Korean in 15 years. Parkson Wright in 1995 to reach a final of the men's singles here at the World Championships. But it's 15-all. And now the Indonesian. On a run of four straight points, goes into the lead. And my mind goes back to his quarter-final yesterday against Lee Chong-wei in the third game. It was 12-all, and he went straight through to 21-12. 9 straight points. Well, you talked about him suddenly putting on a burst.
Again. He worked the opening again.
Land judge.
Soft to the centre, flick off to the rear court. Cross court smash to finish, but just the wrong side of the line.
Of Indonesia. No, just have a little chat to Harry and Garabi. Lovely to see him here in Paris.
16 all.
I remember rightly, Park was actually losing a long way behind in the semi final, and unfortunately, Thomas Sturlaugsson had quite a serious injury that put him out of the game for quite a number of months.
He was 7-3 up from Stora Lorison. This morning game. Good judgment to lead that. Getting it dropped long at the back line.
Seven's over.
Creeping ever closer
16.
To that mark of 21 points.
He's a big point. He's next two now. Very, very good flat game. Pressure in all three of those rallies and managed to come through each of them.
Shot here from Hidalgo.
That is the one that did the damage. Quickly, the Peruan is up and ready again.
Well, how big's this point in the world for match? Lot of effort into the second game. Desperate to finish this in two games now. What can you come up with?
Hot.
He's taking as much time as the umpire will allow him here. Trying to build himself up.
18, 19.
Through. Trying to visualise the serve he's going to hit. Narrow the possible returns down. He's going to go for this point. And a wide serve.
He's pushed that wide too. And now, Parks and Wang.
Service over.
Korea.
Center, game point. 18.
Parky goal there. Tafu's pushed it wide, trying to tempt him into the straight required. And he did his call for it, went back to the middle.
Took courage to leave that. Yes,
mate. Tafu is not short of courage.
So it's over.
Game points has been the same.
19-20.
Oh, I don't believe it. That is unbelievable. Produces the net court to save the second game point.
That's fantastic. Park played a good spin on that return.
It's 20. Extra points required until the clear 2 point win time. Champion in Anaheim 2005.